Welcome to The Full English with me, Matt Riley. We're here today in Robinson's, where this afternoon we're going to unveil the third kit, the white kit, and also to introduce our new squad for the 2014 season. By the way, with the white kit, as ever, it's designed by our chairman, Kun Top, and the story behind it is that the stripe you'll see, the orange stripe across the chest, is a favourite, the colour is a favourite of the fans, and the idea is that that will cover and protect the hearts of the players and also provide a safe situation for the War Elephant logo. So today there's going to be a lot of press and a lot of fans, and this will be replicated all around the country, big clubs especially like Chonburi, Mungtong United and Buri Ram, but also First Division clubs as well. And this is a far cry from 2000, the year 2000, where the international team and the league team were in very, very different situations. In 2000, Peter Weir had just finished as a national coach, and the national team were an unbelievable 43 in the world, a FIFA ranking of 43. But the league was in a very poor state indeed. A lot of the teams were basically government offices, armed forces, and banks. And they'd play out games in front of two, three, or four fans, really not even in a stadium. And there was a lot of problems because nobody was interested. There was no coverage, and of course, there was no fans at all. But things started to change in 2002, and that was when Chonburi, the first provincial club, got involved with the Thai Premier League, and they opened the door for a lot of other provincial clubs. Nowadays, if we fast forward 14 years, the situation has totally reversed. The national team is languishing down in the bottom basement of the FIFA rankings, down with countries like St. Kitts and Nevis. But the league is absolutely booming. The stadiums are developing at a great pace. There's a huge amount of coverage of all the games, all of them are live on True Sports over here, and the players are superstars with BMWs, with boot deals, with TV deals, and like we have today, a great deal of fan support. But a lot of people wonder how far that will go, because at the moment, provincial clubs are in a way propping up the league. If you look at the averages for the Thai Premier League, Buri Ram were the top, the provincial club, and Supandri, I think, came in third with a very, very good attendance indeed. But some of the Bangkok clubs are really struggling, particularly clubs like Police United and TOT. However, generally, especially when compared to the other leagues in ASEAN, the Thai Premier League is really, really doing extremely well. In Asian competitions, also the profile has increased. This year, there will be three teams in the Asian Champions League. Buri Ram will go there by rights, and because they won all three domestic competitions, there's the second place runner-up, which was expected, but also the third place, Chonburi, Mungtong and Chonburi, will go to the qualification rounds. So things seem to be very, very rosy for Thai football at the moment, and certainly being here in Robinson's department store, you can see that there's a great deal of interest in Thai football by Thai people, for Thai people, particularly for the provinces. Supandri FC, ready for ASEAN, ready for the AEC.